So an interesting question came up recently on the forum, and it was about encrypting data on your own Mac. Now the reason you may want to do this is to comply with local laws that say that if you have information about people, personal information like phone numbers and addresses and things like that, that you need to keep that data encrypted. So maybe if you keep a membership list for an organization, you may want to do that. I'm not a lawyer, so I don't know if this is technically needed, but it's easy to technically encrypt data on your Mac. One way to do it is simply to encrypt everything on your Mac. And you may already have this turned on. If you go to System Preferences and you go to Security and Privacy, there's File Vault. And if you turn on File Vault, then everything on your Mac is encrypted. Without entering the user password, all the data is encrypted. Entering the user password, it's going to use that as a key to decrypt data as you access it. So then all your data there is encrypted. Somebody getting hold of just your hard drive and the raw data on it is not going to be able to get anything from that because it's all encrypted data. But if you're not using File Vault or you want an extra layer of encryption on top, you can encrypt data that you store in Pages, Numbers, and Keynote pretty easily. So for instance, here I am in Numbers and I have a list here of names and phone numbers. And let's say I want to store this in an encrypted manner. So I can go to File and then Set Password. And this will turn on encryption for this file. So I have to enter a password here. So I'll just create something here, verify it, a password hint. Now it's important to realize that by encrypting this file, you're not just locking the front door, you're actually encrypting all the data. It's scrambling all of the data in the file. There's no way to get the data unless you have the password. So there's no back door, there's no way to, you know, kind of like get around the password or something like that. So it's important you write down or store in a password manager the password. If you forget it, it's like the file doesn't even exist to you. So you can use a password hint here if you like to give you an idea, something only you would know, to remember which password you're using here. It's probably best to actually make sure you write it down somewhere or store it in a safe place or in several safe places. Now if this is a file you access frequently, you may just want to turn on Remember This Password in My Keychain. So if you're logged onto your Mac, you've entered your user password, so you have access to your keychain data, then you won't have to remember the password. So for you, access becomes easy. But somebody else who gets this file, like you send it to them, they're not going to have your keychain, so they're going to need to know the password. So we'll set the password here, and now we'll save this file. And now if we want to open this file, I'll close it here, we can see the file icon now has a little padlock on it. We go to open it and it opens up automatically because of the keychain access. Let's change that. So we hit change password. Notice how it had the same menu item but it said change password. Oh, you have to enter in the old password and the new password twice. You give a hint, I'm going to remove it from the keychain. And notice there was also a button for remove password there. So now I'll save this. And now when I go to open it, it's going to prompt me, as you can see here, for the password. And at this point, I can also say remember it in my keychain. So now it's an encrypted file and you need password access to get to it. The process is the same for Pages and Keynote. So you go to File, there's Set Password, it looks exactly the same. And you hit Set Password. And then when I save the file, it will now become an encrypted file. And you can see it has that same icon there. The padlock, I go to open it, and it wants me to enter the password in order to get access to the file, to decrypt it using that key.